Pam, where's Lisa?
She's in her trailer. Somebody said she's not feeling good.
Why is the director always the last to know? Lisa, it's time to do it.
I can't go out there.
We'll rehearse the lines if that's what you want, but we're going into overtime.
It's not about the scene, Trevor. I don't feel good, for real.
What's real are jitters. Meryl Streep so gets them.
It's not jitters. I have a headache and I feel like I'm getting a fever or something.
Are you serious?
I'm sorry.
Hey, if you're sick, you're sick.
Thank you for understanding.
I'll just shut it down, send everybody home, and no one gets paid.
You know, you can be a real bastard sometimes.
It's my gift.
Give me a sec. You only get one take, okay?
No problem.
No, I don't think she's acting. Oh my God.
Call 911 now!
Hot sauce?
From New Orleans. It's part of the DMV test.
What is it, like Tabasco?
Tabasco. I put Tabasco in my coffee.
Hey, do you mind?
Knock yourself out.
Has anybody seen Connor?
He's on his way.
Was he in a good mood or a bad mood?
He's in a Connor mood.
Kind of weak.
What is wrong with you people?
Meet up. We leave for Los Angeles in 1 hour.
L.A.?
I just got a request for our help from the Los Angeles County Health Department.
L.A. County? They never ask for our help. What's the case?
They're stumped. It's a cluster of 3 victims. 2 of them died in the last 4 days from what they believe to be an aggressive viral infection.
Is it communicable?
It appears so. Our latest victim, Lisa Van Adams. She collapsed yesterday. She was originally treated in a free clinic in Van Nuys and then transferred to a hospital in Encino where she slipped into a coma last night.
How did the patients present?
All the patients suffer from the same flu-like symptoms. Fever, headaches, limb weakness, and a productive cough with blood.
Any commonalities beyond that?
Yeah. They're all actresses in adult films.
Everyone's at risk in the adult entertainment world. Exposure to disease is part of the job.
You have an expertise in this area?
For the past 15 years, I specialize in treating these performers, and I've seen every kind of communicable disease, but nothing like this.
When did you realize the extent of the problem?
When the third actress came in with similar symptoms, I knew it couldn't be a coincidence.
The third actress, Lisa Van Adams, has she responded to any of the treatments?
Not so far.
Her fever's still high?
As is her white blood cell count, and there's inflammation of the brain. She's trying to fight this off, but she's losing the battle.
Any other symptoms?
The makeup lady, who's also Lisa's friend, said she recently complained of discomfort during urination. Apparently, the 2 deceased victims may have as well.
These could all be symptoms of sexually transmitted diseases.
Yeah, but which STD?
What's wrong? She's so young.
In my experience, they all start out that way.
I'll get blood samples, GC cultures, full blood workups for HIV and STDs.
We ran HIV antibody tests on all 3. None came out positive.
Well, that test can give false negatives. We need to know conclusively, especially if Lisa and the other 2 women were immunosuppressed.
Having their tissues will give me a better chance of isolating the causative agent.
Great. Eva, find out where the first 2 victims are buried. We may need to exhume for autopsy. Miles, monitor Lisa. I want to know the second that her condition changes.
Will do.
Mind if I ask you a favor?
Sure.
Can we please keep the county out of this?
They were the ones who asked us to come here.
Yes, but I would just hate to see this get blown out of proportion before we know what we're dealing with.
We won't sound any alarms until it's absolutely necessary.
I appreciate that.
All right, Frank, start by checking out all three victims' homes.
Aren't we assuming this thing is sexually transmitted?
Yeah, but it's possible this thing was initially misdiagnosed as something else.
All right, then I'll start looking for commonalities in the medicine cabinets and move out from there.
Right. No, and by the way, we're assuming this thing is limited to the porn industry, but until we know for sure...
I got you.
I want somebody to tell me what's wrong with my
sir,
dog.
Hold on.
Let me talk to a doctor.
Let me help
no,
you.
No,
hold on.
No.
Hold on.
No.
Sir, I can help you.
Is there a problem?
Are you a doctor?
I'm Dr. Stephen Connor with the NIH. How can I help you?
I want to see Lisa. I just want to see my daughter.
Follow me.
I got this phone call saying Lisa's in the hospital. Flew in, got here as fast as I could. How did this happen?
Your daughter's illness may be related to her occupation.
Don't soft serve it up to me, doctor. They told me what she's been doing with her life, and I gotta tell you, it took me more than a while to get my head around that one.
How your daughter earned a living is of no concern to us.
It's what I deserve, I guess. I haven't always been the world's greatest father to Lisa.
Look, Mr. Graybridge, you don't have to explain.
Look, a year ago, depending on who you had asked, she either ran away from home or I kicked her out. I've been looking for her, but we haven't talked since then. Is she gonna die?
Your daughter has an aggressive infection, the source of which we don't understand yet. But trust me, Lisa's in good hands. Dr. McCabe, this is Ben Graybridge, Lisa's father. Whatever you need, Dr. McCabe will help you out. Anything you need.
You know, in my day, the whole porn business was underground. Now, they got conventions celebrating it in Las Vegas. And the girls came back bragging about it.
You mean Lisa Van Adams and the other two actresses who got sick?
Well, no, I'd never seen those other two till you showed me the pictures. I'm talking about Lisa's roommate.
Lisa had a roommate?
Yeah, it's her right there, Brianna Hobart.
So Lisa's roommate was also in the business?
Brianna retired from the business.
What happened?
I don't know all the details. I'd overhear them talking sometimes, and Brianna just had enough. So she packed up and moved home.
When?
2 days ago. Strange, too, because she was complaining about not feeling well.
She say what was wrong?
Some kind of bad flu. Fever, aches and pains.
She left here feeling like that?
Yeah, Lisa told her not to drive feeling that way, but Brianna just wanted to go home.
Did you ever overhear where home was?
Someplace in the Midwest, I think. I don't know for sure. And I just mind my own business.
Yeah.
Thank you.
All right. Let's start with what we know. Eva.
I just got confirmation that the two deceased actresses were cremated.
Along with the evidence of what killed them.
Nat?
Nothing on Lisa's blood cultures yet, but without being able to autopsy the first two victims, finding what we're up against just became a lot more difficult.
First two victims' places were clean, but they may not be the only other victims. Brianna Hobart, Lisa's roommate, was also in the business. She may have presented before Lisa.
Where is she?
Moved back home. No one seems to know where.
Eva, contact the producers of these movies. Find out where this girl is from and where she's headed.
Yep.
Miles, how's Lisa?
Her condition's worsened in the last 6 hours rapidly, and there's been a left shift in her white blood cell count.
Her body's going after it with everything it has.
Sure is, but it may only be a matter of time till she runs out of gas.
How much longer does she have?
It's hard to tell. At this moment, all we can do is hope that she keeps on fighting.
We can rule out HIV. She is negative.
It could be a form of disseminated gonorrhea. That could cause septic shock. I saw my fair share of co-eds with it during my residency.
College students are a walking petri dish for the stuff.
What regimen did you put these co-eds on?
Cipro and ceftriaxone.
All right, try it again. See if it helps.
Will do.
Frank, let you and I take a drive.
Where are we going?
Find out how they make movies.
At least the health department had the foresight to secure this set.
Let's hope we can find whatever they couldn't.
$9 billion a year. Movies, DVDs, internet. You think it'll be a little more glamorous. You know, I read in an article that said most women in this business were from dysfunctional families and were looking for love and adoration.
Our job is to stop diseases, not judge those who have them.
Look, I'm not judging anyone here, but you have to admit, with all the diseases out there, it's a hell of a way to earn a buck. Hey, check this out. Looks like our sick actress was taking more than aspirin for her headaches.
Oxycontin.
And we both know Oxycontin is a painkiller that's as abused as hell.
It's also been known to depress the respiratory system.
Well, maybe we're looking for adult stars with addictions, which would definitely complicate things.
Complications is something that we don't have time for right now.
My wife was suffering from the same symptoms?
Exact. Mrs. Jenna Kirkland, 37-year-old mother of three.
When did she present?
She collapsed about 4 hours ago. The emergency room doctor read Eva's notice and contacted us as soon as Mrs. Kirkland was admitted.
Housewife from the Valley and a porn star from Hollywood Hills. I wonder where their lives intersect.
Well, I guess we'll be finding out soon.
I don't suppose Mrs. Kirkland's an adult film star. So she's definitely an outlier from the initial cluster.
When you get back, check Mrs. Kirkland and Lisa for traces of OxyContin. Frank and I found some in Lisa's dressing room. Maybe something, maybe nothing. But however it's connected, this thing is spreading. We have to figure out how.
Nothing infectious or toxic, but I found more weight loss supplements, diet pills, and
exercise gimmicks than you see in your average night of infomercials. And Mrs. Kirkland seemed to have just bought a new wardrobe, several sizes smaller.
Double check the other victims' homes. See if any of them were using diet supplements.
You think this stuff could be the source of the infection?
Well, Lisa Van Adams and the other actresses' lives are worlds apart from Jenna Kirkland's, but this might be the link.
All right.